big round number. When she looked at herself, she just saw a hole right in her center. Every day she watched the numbers line up. She wanted to count too.
But how could a number worth nothing become something? Zero felt empty inside. She watched one having fun with the others.
One was solid and strong with bold strokes and squared corners. Zero was big and round with no corners at all. If I were like one, then I could count too, she thought.
So she pushed and pulled and stretched and straightened. She forced and flattened and finally became.
Zero, she said, becoming like one was too much of a stretch. Eight and nine rolled into the scene. If you doubled yourself up, you'd be like me, said eight. So Zero twisted and turned to try to be like eight. Or you could be a nine with a longer line, said nine. So Zero pinched and puckered to try to be nine.
But Zero could only be Zero. We're on our way to join the others. Come count with us, they said. Zero felt deflated. Eight and nine were numbers with value. Of course they'd count. How could they know what she felt?
Zero had a new thought. If she could impress the numbers that give her value, she'd leap, she'd soar, she'd sizzle, she'd shine. She'd make a grand entrance and floor them all. Zero began to go faster and faster and faster. She leaped flying, soaring, rampaging.
This is a pretty long book, so we're just going to end it off here. You can find the rest of the book in Los Altos Library. Thank you.